Hello internet, what is going on, and welcome to Top 5 Scary Videos, the channel where we compile the most terrifying tales from the deepest depths of the internet so you can get absolutely horrified from the comfort of your own phone. My name's Jack Finch and today I'll be your host as we check out 5 scary times that NASA was wrong. Now, I'm sure, like me, we all love NASA, that exciting, innovative space agency that dares to dream of a world where galactic travel is as normal as riding a bus. But, you know, space is a pretty unforgiving place, and it's scary how little room for error there is when you're basically trying to launch a giant can of molten fire from one planet to another purely by the magical power of mathematics. NASA has launched a total of 135 missions between 1981 and 2011, totaling an insane 1,322 days of flight time. But in space, no one can hear you scream, and sometimes NASA can get it very, very wrong. Jumping in at number 5, we have Skylab. Although it sounds like something straight out of a James Bond film, Skylab was NASA's first ever all-American space station. It was a sheer engineering masterclass too, including a workshop, solar observatory, and all the features necessary to sustain a 3-person crew. And they did all of this in 1973, just 4 years after the moon landings. Skylab was in orbit for a little over 6 years, and its life cycle came to an end in 1979, happily enough. But where NASA really dropped the ball was, well, they didn't really think about how they'd get it back down again. This was pretty uncharacteristic for NASA, you know, because you can't just really blag your way into rocket science, and preparation is key when you're launching tons of pure metal into the sky. Well, no one really remembers Skylab, but what they do remember is the crash, because it was absolutely huge and received worldwide media coverage. Before it came hurtling down to Earth again, NASA finally got to crunching the numbers and calculated a 1 in 152 chance of human injury. They figured that their best bet was to use Skylab's remaining rockets to guide it over the Indian Ocean, and for the most part, they succeeded. The larger parts of Skylab came hurtling down into the sea, but the majority of debris landed over poor old Australia. Thankfully, no one was seriously injured, and Australia remained relatively undamaged. NASA could finally stop holding their breath and give each other a high five over the fact that a giant space station didn't land on anyone. Not everyone was happy though, and shortly afterwards, the small Australian shire of Esperance fined NASA $400 for littering. Coming in at number 4, we have the Mars Polar Lander. The Mars Polar Lander, or the MPL for short, remains to be one of NASA's most ambitious projects to date. Launched on January 3rd, 1999, the MPL was a 290-kilogram robotic vessel with the primary objective of surveying the southern pole region of Mars and search for evidence of ancient Martian climates. With the MPL, NASA also wanted to ask the question, can the red planet sustain life? Well, the curious probe finally reached its destination in December 1999, and just as it made its graceful descent through the Martian atmosphere, it fell off the face of the universe, and NASA has no idea where it went. Communication with the MPL up and died and never resumed, and no one, especially NASA, really knew what the hell had just happened. They spent a full month trying to get the lander to text back, frantically spamming "please respond," until finally NASA gave up the ghost and declared the mission an absolute failure. Although they're not entirely sure, NASA's best theory is that the MPL's onboard computer had been tricked into thinking it had already landed, but in reality had shut off its engines prematurely and crashed dead into the big red rock. The truth though still remains a mystery. Coming in at number 3, we have the infamous Apollo 13. The infamous Apollo 13 mission was so insane that they made it into a Hollywood blockbuster starring Tom Hanks. Launched on April 11th, 1970, Apollo 13 was planned to be NASA's third manned mission to the moon. The mission was led by veteran pilot Commander Jim Lovell and had a relatively straightforward agenda: land on the moon and explore a 50-mile-wide crater. Well, from the beginning, beginning, things started to unravel, and the whole mission never really got back on the right foot. To begin, one of Apollo 13's primary astronauts, Ken Mattingly, contracted rubella and had to be admitted to hospital. Because of that, a pilot named Jack Swigert took up his place, and although astronauts train extensively for months and months, this was Swigert's first ever time flying into space. The bad luck didn't stop there though. Shortly into the mission, an onboard cryogenic tank burst open and damaged another in the process. Apollo 13 lost its ability to generate power, maintain oxygen levels, and produce water. Pretty scary when you're essentially floating around the lifeless void of space in a tin can. This is where we get the infamous line, "Houston, we have a problem." And a pretty big problem at that. The mission was scrapped, and the astronauts soon forgot anything about the moon. They turned back with things looking pretty damn dire. There was some good luck though. Apollo 13 still had a functioning backup, and the crew were able to survive inside there during the trip back home, before switching to the original craft on re-entry. That's one hell of a U-turn. Next up at number two, we have the Challenger disaster. On January 28, 1986, seven brave crew members of the Space Shuttle Challenger were tragically killed in NASA's first fatal accident during a planned Space Shuttle launch. Five astronauts and two payload specialists made up the flight roster, and after just 73 seconds from its launch point, the vessel broke apart off the coast of Cape Canaveral and plummeted into the ocean. Over 17% of Americans actually witnessed the disaster live on national television due to crew member Krista McAuliffe, who was planned to be the first ever teacher in space and had attracted a buzz from the media. It was concluded that the disaster originated from a certain joint used to seal the spacecraft, the O-ring, a manufactured part that NASA had used despite warnings that it couldn't withstand cold conditions, was identified as the primary cause for the launch disaster and the seven tragic deaths of its brave crew members. Shortly afterwards, NASA suspended all space shuttle programs for 32 months while they tried to learn from their tragic mistake. Which leads us to our final number one point, the Columbia disaster. Because on February 1st, 2003, tragedy struck again for NASA and its crew members. The fateful launch was planned to be Space Shuttle Columbia's 28th mission into orbit. During the launch, a piece of foam used for insulation had broken off from the ship's tank and catastrophically damaged its left wing. As the Columbia entered Earth's atmosphere again, the damage to the left wing allowed searing atmospheric gases to break through its heat shield, causing the spacecraft to tragically break apart as it made its way home. After a detailed report, it was concluded that the crew had less than a minute before the vessel depressurized, knocking them unconscious before the cabin disintegrated. It was also concluded that the astronauts couldn't have known that the Columbia had a fatal flaw in its design, although NASA went to great lengths after the disaster to ensure that it would never, ever happen again. The world went on to remember the brave crew members that gave their lives in the pursuit of space exploration. Husband, McCool, Anderson, Ramon, Chola, Brown, and Clark. NASA's shortcomings and oversights led to the deaths of 14 pilots over two separate shuttle disasters, and is a mortal reminder of the incredible danger that surrounds spaceflight and the human cost that sadly comes with it. That's all we've got time for today, folks. Make sure to hit that subscribe button, leave us a comment in the box down below, and maybe hit that thumbs up button while you're down there. My name's Jack Finch. I sincerely hope you've enjoyed this video, and until next time, take it easy.